What's going on, everyone? It's Semp. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we are busting out the theories for the Falcon and the Winter Soldier because head writer Malcolm Spellman has teased that a new character is coming to the MCU in episode 5, so I'm going to give you my thoughts on who that may be. Before we start, though, if you're new to the channel or if you just like Marvel, the MCU, comics, and everything in between, subscribe and leave a like if you enjoy. New videos are posted weekly, but other than that, let's get into the video. Let's go. Alright, so apparently we're supposed to be getting a new character in the MCU in episode 5. The writer of the show, Malcolm Spellman, talked about how he would love to see this character with Thor, and how the character is very grounded but grand on a new scale. So I'm going to go over a couple quick options. Most of these are probably not going to happen whatsoever, so skip ahead if you just want to learn about the Songbird information. But when I was first thinking about this, I honestly figured that we would be getting another troll like in WandaVision, and while I found that trolling somewhat funny and more ambiguous, this character tease seems much more legit and not just a different version of Paul Bettany, although shout out to the White Vision because those scenes were epic. Honestly, I did think the character at first was Noobmaster 69, and hear me out. Me and my buddy Colin on the podcast talked about this. We found out that Noobmaster is actually Aaron a few weeks back. He was the Apple employee in the Winter Soldier movie back in 2014, and then of course we got our intro to Noobmaster in Endgame, in which Thor yells at him over the in-game microphone. And before Falcon and Winter Soldier started, Anthony Mackie as the Falcon, Microsoft Xbox, and Aaron teamed up for a commercial where Aaron was revealed that his gamertag was actually Noobmaster 69. And so being that Spellman said that he would love to see this character with Thor, it wouldn't be a huge shock to see something like this if they were in fact trolling, and honestly, it would be pretty funny. However, in terms of the tone of this show, I'm not too sure if it would fit in within the larger story, but it's possible.
My gamertag is Noobmaster 69. My cousin made it.
The other two ideas I had were Arnim Zola and, of course, the Power Broker. Now, Zola isn't a new character, and I know we haven't seen his robotic form return, shout out to that comic version. However, they actually did have concept art of this for the 2015 anime movie, but it was scrapped and we actually saw an AI version of Zola in 2014's The Winter Soldier, so that idea was likely scrapped, but it's still a possibility. And of course, the big one right now, who is the Power Broker? I think it could very well be the Power Broker as we are getting closer and closer to his reveal. In episode 3, they refer to the Power Broker in masculine forms, and I believe Zemo does actually specifically say he. I'll go into more depth on the Power Broker, but I do think that the Power Broker is a new character and actually someone that they were casting a while back, codenamed under the Benefactor. The description for the Benefactor was a Norman Osborn type character, so let's wait for episode 4 and then I'll touch a little bit more on that theory. But I do think that the Power Broker is a possibility. However, what you've been waiting for and why you clicked on this video most likely, Songbird debuting in episode 5 of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, let's break it down. Now if you don't know who Melissa Gold is, or otherwise known as Songbird in the comics, she debuted as her supervillainous self-titled Screaming Mimi in Marvel 2-in-1 issue number 54 in August of 1979. As Screaming Mimi, her enhanced vocal cords were bionically altered and enhanced by technicians from Roxxon Corp. It was an oil company, among other things, in Marvel Comics, and they have ties to creating the Atom Bomb as well as already having appeared in the Iron Man trilogy within the MCU. So Songbird has the ability to generate a high-pitched supersonic scream that has a variety of effects depending on the note that she keys, so each note can deliver a different result to its enemy, such as dizziness, nausea, hallucinations, and a whole bunch more. Her powers are crazy and also include some super speed and more so. When she became Songbird, she actually started using technology created by Ulysses Klaue. He created a sound emitter that turns sound into legit three-dimensional objects, a term known as solid sound. So why is this important? Well, obviously because we have seen Klaue's existence and what his tech and vibranium can create within the MCU, but not to full capacity. So like with everything in the Marvel Universe, it's a possibility that she already has this tech, and knowing that Ayo has just appeared in Falcon and Winter Soldier, a possible Wakandan and Songbird collaboration debut together could make a whole lot of sense. One thing I want to point out is that Atlanta Filming, if you go check out his Twitter and socials, he visits and films a lot of sets, and while he isn't a verified and confirmed scooper, he actually replied to someone the other day when they asked him about the episode 5 character, and he said she hasn't been seen yet. So the fact that he says this does narrow down our options a bit. So it could be Noobmaster or the Power Broker, but like I said, they kind of refer to the Power Broker as a he. Now that's not the end all be all or any sort of universal terms, but it's something to point out. And the Sharon Carter theories really don't make any sense, so that's why I'm leading to it being Songbird. Being that Songbird is in nature a very grounded character, which also fits into Spellman's description, in the comics she starts off with an iteration of the Grapplers team, and this is where it gets really interesting. So the grapplers in need of enhancement sought out to the women's division of the superpowered UCWF, the Unlimited Class Wrestling Federation. Their manager, Auntie Freeze, who was a wrestler in this federation, had the Power Broker enhance them. So while other grapplers received superhuman strength, Mimi, which was her name at the time like we talked about, had her vocal enhancements internalized as a throat implant, which we may see the story they use in the MCU. And so when the grapplers broke up, Zemo recruited her to join his Masters of Evils team, which is basically what I think we will get in the MCU at first, or as a mix with the Thunderbolts, but ultimately the team will be called the Thunderbolts, as many rumors and leaks have hinted at. The name Songbird was born when she became a member of that team. Songbird just makes a whole lot of sense to be the new character teased, and as we all know, the somewhat fun guy that we saw as Zemo in episode 3 is about to turn bad real quick. Baron Zemo is always thinking ahead and outside the box, and he has a secret agenda right now. And I think that agenda is starting the formation of the Thunderbolts iteration that we're about to see in the MCU. And maybe he has been in contact with Ross, and as we know, William Hurt is in the Black Widow movie, and there have been a lot of Red Hulk rumors and post-credit rumors of him slowly assembling this team. Obviously different in the MCU, but the original Civil War event in the comics included the Thunderbolts, and Songbird was approached by the government to catch supervillains and rehabilitate them. Similar to what we may see Ross do in the MCU, pardoning anti-heroes by recruiting him to fight back against heroes like the Avengers, it's possible Songbird needs this also, and she has been in Madripoor all this time. And even in episode 3, we see Zemo say, "I spent years hunting people that Hydra recruited to recreate the serum, because once it's out there, someone can create an army of people like the Avengers." And then he looks at his mask and his theme song plays in the background, had a very sinister feel to it. The way I took this as though he's going to realize he can't do it all himself, and maybe he already realized that, and this will lead to his assembling of an early Masters of Evil team or the Thunderbolts team with General Ross, because remember, Zemo could use a pardon also right now. So if he fails again in this series, who better than to offer him that opportunity to work with a power team, Thunderbolt Thaddeus Ross. There's a lot to unpack in this video and a whole lot of moving parts that I'll have to dive into at a later date, but I just wanted to propose the idea that Songbird could appear in episode 5 and maybe where the show is heading down the road with the Thunderbolts. So if you have any questions or concerns, let me know in the comments below, and if you've been really enjoying the videos, leave a like, but also share this with a friend or wherever you watch the content. The more people who watch, the more I can hopefully put out, so go ahead and share. For all announcements and to keep up to date with my content though, follow me at AnotherMarvelGuy on Twitter. All links to my socials are below, including where you can find the podcast. And we're closing in on 250 subs, so make sure you're subscribed with the notification bells turned on so you don't miss any new videos. And other than that, I just want to say thank you. I'm Another Marvel Guy, and I'll catch y'all on the blip.